Dr. John Lipman again from the Atlanta Fibroid Center. A lot of patients will ask me, why do African-American women disproportionately suffer with fibroid tumors? Two reasons. One, genetically, it runs stronger in African-American families. And second, has to do with how fibroids grow. While nobody knows where fibroids come from, once they arrive, they grow with estrogen and progesterone, hormones. That's why they grow sometimes very rapidly during pregnancy, and why they tend not to be an issue for a woman once she's in menopause. Estrogen is stored in fat. And so one of the things that everybody can do to try to improve on their fibroid symptoms is lose any excess body fat. Everyone knows kind of what their ideal body weight should be based on their frame. No one's saying you have to be skinny, but everybody has their ideal body weight. And so losing excess body fat and getting closer to your ideal body weight will help your fibroid symptoms. We incorporate exercise and weight loss along with healthy eating choices to improve your fibroid symptoms. As I mentioned, fibroids grow with estrogen. So there are three important points I want to make about the dietary stuff that will help your fibroid symptoms. First, you want to try to moderate or get rid of the estrogenic foods in your diet. The big offenders are red meat, non-organic chicken, and dairy. You can do substitutions, almond milk instead of cow milk for the dairy products. You can do organic free-range chicken instead of the non-organic for chicken. Beef's a little harder. There are some beef substitutes, some containing soys, and soy is kind of a mixed bag because some soy products have phytoestrogens, which may be beneficial because they can compete with estrogen for the same receptors and in a sense block estrogen, which is a good thing. You can increase the amount of anti-estrogenic foods. Colored fruits and vegetables have compounds in them called flavonoids, and flavonoids are excellent antioxidants and anti-estrogenic foods because they have, the flavonoids block an important enzyme for estrogen production. And the third point is making sure that you have an adequate vitamin D. Now, vitamin D is actually not really a vitamin, technically speaking. It's a pro-hormone because it gets activated inside the body to its activated form. So it's really a pro-hormone, but be that as it may, vitamin D is a really important compound and really important to make sure you have adequate vitamin D levels because it's your anti-fibroid vitamin, if you will. Vitamin D has a lot of really important qualities. There's evidence to suggest if you have an adequate vitamin D level, that is your very best way to kind of prevent fibroids from happening and prevent fibroids from growing. Unfortunately, very few African Americans, both men and women, have adequate vitamin D levels. Many studies show roughly 10% of African Americans have adequate vitamin D, and that's because of the pigmentation of their skin. And how we get vitamin D into our bodies is through sunlight and processes that convert cholesterol into a form of vitamin D, which is activated in our bodies. And so the darker the pigmentation of your skin, the harder it is to get adequate vitamin D levels. And so every year when a woman goes to her yearly examination, yearly checkup, it is really important to check the vitamin D level because it's so easy to supplement. If you look, a lot of the grocery stores and shops that sell vitamins, they come as either 1,000 or maybe 2,000 international units for each pill, each capsule. And usually anywhere from 1,000 to maybe 4,000 international units a day is adequate for most people to maintain, even if you're slightly low on vitamin D or even significantly low, getting that supplementation to the right level is very important. Now, some people need quite a bit more. Some may even get 50,000 international units a week. But for anything more than 4,000 international units a day, you should really be under the care of a physician to monitor your vitamin D levels appropriately. But the main message is make sure you check your vitamin D yearly and make sure that you have adequate vitamin D levels, because that's one of the things that you can actually control. You can't pick your parents. You can't do anything about the genetic predisposition for fibroids in African American people. But what you can control is your weight and your eating habits and your exercise, and make sure that you have adequate vitamin D levels.